Okay, we've got to 111 now. Just there. Right. Now, it's been suggested to me that it might be a good idea for me to talk about what's actually happening to the baby, because this has tended to be too much about me, not enough about this. And so, I just want to point out, this is the first week of the third trimester, and the third trimester, and the last trimester, is the point from which the baby becomes viable. My brother was born 12 weeks premature, which is the stage that this baby is now at. So this is now basically no longer a fetus, really, but more of an actual baby. It's pretty well grown. It has convoluted brain hemispheres. It's making breathing movements on its own, although it's not breathing because obviously it breathes via the placenta. It's starting to build up a bit of body fat, and so it can insulate itself from the outside. And I know from the fact that my brother survived that it's possible for a baby to survive at this stage. And I wanted to talk about the experience. I remember I had a conversation with a friend of mine once when she was pregnant, saying, is it like carrying a baby, you know those baby carriers, carrying a baby carrier? It's like a baby in a baby carrier, but inside you. And she said, no, it's nothing like that, because of the organs that it affects, because obviously a baby on the outside is not going to be kicking internal organs and that kind of thing, which is what happens. It is happening now inside me. And so, yeah, that is a very different thing. But in a way, I'm a human baby buggy. I mean, this baby is now viable. Wouldn't really want it to survive outside an incubator. And in a sense, we're at the off-ramp now, because this baby could be taken out of me and maybe survive, which is a good thing. But I'm so much more than a baby carrier, because I'm also providing the oxygen, the food, carrying away the waste products, carbon dioxide and that kind of thing, and keeping it safe. And it is very safe. I mean, it's as safe as it can be inside a man's body. That's quite nice. I want to keep it safe. It's good. So, other things are happening further up at the moment. Basically, I am getting a little bit of breast development. I think I need to concentrate on now trying to build up the actual galactagogue herbs, which are the herbs that increase breast milk secretion. I had to catch up, basically. It's not important that I have big breasts, but I do need to have breasts that will secrete milk. So I was trying to catch up, and I've got to that point. But what I'm experiencing is some aching up here, which I think is the Cooper's ligaments that keep the breast shape. Basically, the weight of the breast is slightly bigger. I mean, I know they're not huge. They don't need to be huge. But, yeah, you get pain. I get pain and aching up here. I also get weird responses to high-pitched noises, basically, like babies' cries, and also to emotional things. I get tingling, and I get pains along here as well. So that's all a bit strange. So I was thinking about the idea of bras, and I think, well, a bra is, you know, something that they're trying to get you to buy. But on the other hand, maybe a male breast needs support because it doesn't have quite so much in the way of toughness. I think female breasts are tougher because they're sort of designed to hold quite a lot of weight, whereas male breast, not really, it's just sort of drooping there. So that's a bit weird. I don't know if you can see it. I'm going to bring myself up to you, unzip myself as usual, and shift myself so you can see what's going on. Obviously, you've got this pregnant belly there, getting bigger every week. By the way, I should have uploaded a slideshow by now. So just to turn around, slip a bit of movement there, slowly, and there it is. But also, it might be interesting what's going on further up. Now, I'm going to try and get a profile there. If you look very carefully, you can see that that's not quite flat. It doesn't have to be much more than flat, of course. It just needs to have... You see that there as well? And also, the nipples have changed shape. Now, what I was thinking of doing with that, there, that's fairly obvious, I think. Now, what I was thinking of doing was to use that to stimulate. I wanted a breast pump, basically, so that I could stimulate that and see if I could start producing milk. So if anybody happens to have a breast pump, please let me know and maybe post it to me or something, because that would be really useful. So I was looking in the shops, and I can't really afford them. They're 25 quid or something. So that would be brilliant if you could do that. So, yeah, that's me for today. Human baby buggy. I've got about 12 weeks to go. This is the third trimester. This is the home straight. So this is going to be a bit of a roller coaster ride, really. And I'll sort of see how far I can get. But at least I know that this baby can survive without me if needs absolutely be. So I'll see you next week. Just a quick look. Here we go. And goodbye.